Welcome back to the course of Digital Electronics. Today we will see designing of high order multiplexer using low order multiplexers. That means, for example, designing of 16 by 1 multiplexer using 4 by 1 multiplexer, designing of 16 by 1 using 8 by 1, designing of 32 by 1 using 4 by 1 and also 8 by 1, designing of 4 by 1 using 2 by 1. It is clear. That means this is example. You can able to design the high order multiplexers, whatever it may be, using the low order multiplexers. Okay, now to design this, first of all, the three steps should be remember very clearly. The first step should be you have to match the inputs. The second step should be only one output should be present. Why? Because we are discussing about multiplexer. We know that multiplexer contains only one output. That is very important point here. Okay, the first step should be match the input. The second step, you have to consider only one output. That means only one output should be present at the end. Then finally, the third step is you have to give the selection lines. Is it clear? Now we will see some of the examples regarding this. Now if you observe that, the first example I have considered is designing of 4 by 1 multiplexer using 2 by 1 multiplexer. Now first thing is we have to match the inputs. That means we require 4 inputs. Since we have to use 2 by 1 multiplexer, since to match the inputs, I required 2 2 by 1 multiplexers. Is it clear? Now observe that here I am going to use, let us consider this is one 2 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, this is another 2 by 1 multiplexer. This is another 2 by 1 multiplexer. Now we know that multiplexer contains only one output. If you observe that this is an output here. Okay. Now let us consider A, B, C, D are the inputs. Okay, this 2 by 1 multiplexer contains one output, this 2 by 1 multiplexer contains one output. But we know that in step 2, we should have only one output. Therefore, these two inputs should be given to one more 2 by 1 multiplexer. Now if you observe that one more 2 by 1 multiplexer, then finally only one output is going to be considered. Now the step 3 should be, we have to give the selection lines. Okay, I'm going to give the selection line. Why? Because since for a 4 by 1 multiplexer, we know that for a 4 by 1 multiplexer, we require two selection lines, 4 inputs, only one output. Now if you observe that here, how many inputs are there? A, B, C, D, 4 inputs. Let us consider these are the selection lines. I'm going to consider this one as S1 selection line, this one as S0 selection line. Observe that I am going to give the selection line in reverse order. Okay, that means here I am giving the most significant bit selection line. Here I am giving the least significant bit selection line. Now if you observe that, one output. One output, four inputs, two selection lines. If you observe that, overall it is a 4 by 1 multiplexer. Now we will cross check the operation. We know that S1, S0, okay, this is Y. Okay, this is a truth table of it. We know that for 0, 0, okay, A should be passed to Y. For 0, 1, B should be passed to Y. For 1, 0, C should be passed to Y. For 1, 1, D should be passed to Y. Okay, now if you observe that, this is the truth table. Now, we will see this truth table with the help of operation of it. Now, if you observe very clearly. Now, first of all, this is 0. The S0 is 0, S1 is 0. Now if you observe that, since this selection line is 0, it selects this output. Now similarly, this selection line is 0, it selects this output. Now if you observe that A is passed to Y. Are you clear? Now similarly, let us consider the next combination. We will consider the next combination. That is what? 0-1 combination. Now if you observe that S1 is 0, S0 is 1 now. S1 is 0. S0 is 1. For this combination, I am going to talk about. Okay, S1 is 0 itself, S0 is 1. Now, if you observe that since it is 0, this will select this one. Now, since it is 1, this will select this. Now, if you observe that B is passed to Y. Similarly, for the next combination, what is the next combination? Okay, 1-0 combination. That means S1 should be 1, S1 should be 1, S0 should be 0. Now, if you observe that here, since it is 1, it will select this one. Since this is 0, the same selection line here, this is 0, it will select C. Okay, in this manner. Now similarly, if you observe that for 1-1 combination, if you observe that, I will use a different color for this. Okay, I will use a different color. Now if you observe that, okay, for 1-1 combination it is 1, here it is 1, therefore it will select D. In this manner, the operation will be clear. Now, very important point, you have to match the inputs and you have to produce only one output, and the selection line should be given in the reverse order. That means from MSB to LSB. Is it clear? Now we will see one more example here. Designing of 16 by 1 multiplexer using, if you observe that designing of 16 by 1 multiplexer, I will take using 2 by 1 itself for first of all. Now you, to match how many 2 by 1 multiplexers are required to match the inputs to 16, 8. That means observe that 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, 7, sorry for that, 7. Now finally, if you observe that, 8, this is the 8th one. Now each contains two inputs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now there is a common selection line for this one. Now this is a common selection line. Now first of all, you have to think very important point for a 16 by 1 multiplexer. Okay, we contain how many selection lines? 4 selection lines. That is an important point. Now if you observe that here, once again each 2 by 1 multiplexer contains one output. Therefore this 2 will be given to one more 2 by 1. This will be given to one more 2 by 1. This will be given to one more 2 by 1. This will be given to one more 2 by 1. Now this one should be given to one more 2 by 1. This one should be given to one more 2 by 1. And finally, this 2 will be given to one more 2 by 1. Now if you observe that 1, 2, I will use different color for that. Okay, now if you observe that this is a red color one, 1, 2, 3, this is 4. Now let us observe that S3, S2, S1, S0. Is it clear? In this manner, you have to design a 16 by 1 multiplexer using 2 by 1 multiplexers. Now we will take one more example here. If you observe that one more example I am going to talk about here. Okay, designing of 16 by 1 multiplexer using 4 by 1 multiplexer. Now to match the inputs, how many number of 4 by 1 required? 4 4 by 1s are required. Now if you observe that 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now each 4 by 1, we know that for a 4 by 1 multiplexer, we require 2 selection lines. Okay. Now only one output for a multiplexer. Now if you observe that 1, 2, 3, 4, one more 4 by 1 mux we required here. 4 by 1 mux, only one output, 2 selection lines. Now we know that for 16 by 1, we require 4 selection lines. If you observe here, okay. This is S3, this will be S2, this will be S1, this will be S0. In this manner, you can able to design, okay, 16 by 1 multiplexer using 4 by 1 multiplexer. Now, if you observe that, some more examples I will consider here. Okay, let us consider, okay, 16 by 1 using 16 by 1, if you observe the 16 by 1 using 8 by 1 multiplexer. 16 by 1 using 8 by 1, if you observe that. Now how many 8 by 1s are required? 2 8 by 1s are required, that's it. Okay, one output here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. We know that for 8 by 1 multiplexer, 3 selection lines are required, the same selection line for this. Here if you observe that only one output is present, therefore here we required a 2 by 1 multiplexer help to design a 16 by 1 multiplexer using 8 by 1 multiplexer. Then finally it is 1, therefore it is 8 by 1 mux, it is also 8 by 1 mux. Okay, this is one selection line. This will be S3, this will be S2, this will be S0, this will be S1, this will be S0. In this manner you can able to design. Now let us consider yourself, try to perform this one, 32 by 1 multiplexer using 8 by 1 multiplexer. Using 8 by 1. Now let us try to do. How many 8 by 1s are required? 4 8 by 1s are required. 1, 2, 3, 4. Each 8 by 1 consists of one output. This is 8 by 1 mux. All are 8 by 1 mux itself. Similarly, 8 by 1 mux. Here also it is 8 by 1 mux. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Here since 8 by 1 we require 3 selection lines, 3 3 3. Now if you observe that since here we are having only 4 in 4 outputs are there for each and every mux, therefore I required the help of what? 4 by 1 mux. This is an output, how many selection lines? 2 selection lines. Now if you observe that it is S4, it should be S3, it should be S2, S1, S0. Why? Because for a 32 by 1 we required 5 selection lines. 5 selection lines. It is clear? Okay, in this manner you can able to design a high order multiplexer using low order multiplexer. Okay, thank you very much for each and everyone. Have a nice day. If you are having any queries, please comment it. Okay, thank you very much.